In this video, I want to show you how to create a relief map in ArcGIS. So let's go to ArcGIS. In ArcGIS, let's bring in the data we want to use. So for this exercise, we are going to use digital elevation model. So click on add data, navigate to your folder where you have the data. So I want to use this digital elevation model, and I'm using the shape file of my study area as well, and click on add. The digital elevation model for this exercise has been added, so I can check the symbology of my study area to hollow, and let me make it red. Click on OK. Yes, I have my digital elevation model and my study area. So to produce relief map from this digital elevation model, there are few things we need to do. So one of the things we need to do is to create grids around our study area. From there, we are going to extract values from this digital elevation model, which we will use to produce the relief map. So to do that, come to search. If you can't find search here, this is search. If we click on it, it will open the search box like this. So here, search for create fishnet. Then click on search. So this is it. Create fishnet under data management. Click on it. It will open create fishnet box. So here, output feature class. Click here and navigate to your folder where you want to save it. Let's call this one grid. Click on save. Then here, template extents. So click on the drop down. I want it to be the same as my study area or my digital elevation model. Then scroll down. This cell size width, I want it to be 3000 meter, which means I want to create a cell grid around my study area, which are 3000 meter by 3000 meter. So also here it will be 3000. Then the number of row here, I want to make it 50. Here also, I want to make it 50. Then scroll down. Here, create label point. This is very important. This is exactly what we need. So make sure you check this create label points. Then here, geometry type, change it to polygon. And after that, click on OK. It will run and create grids that are 3000 by 3000 meter around our study area. Yes, it has been created. However, it's more than our study area. So come to this grid, change it to hollow. Click on OK. Yes, this point is what we actually need, because it's the one we will use to extract value from our digital elevation to this point. But the points are more than our study area. So what to do? Let's uncheck this grid. So come to selection. Select by location. Here, we want to select, let me bring this here. We want to select this grid label, that is this point that fall within our study area. So check this grid label. So here, change it to your study area. So we want to select the points that are within our study area. Click on apply to see. So you can see now only the points within our study area has been selected. You can now click on OK. Then what to do? Right click here and export the selected points as shapefile. So click, right click and come to data. Click export data. Navigate to your folder where you want to save it. So let's just save it as samples, for instance. Then click on save and click on OK. So click on yes to add it to map. So we can now clear selected and uncheck this. Come to this sample, right click and open the attribute table. Now we can see FID, shape and ID. So this ID, we want to use it, this column, to create serial number for all these points. So what to do is to right click here, open the feed calculator, click yes. Then here, the ID is equal to the FID plus 1. Click on OK. So it has created serial number for it. So now, close this. But the next thing we want to do, we want to extract values from the digital elevation model to this point. There are many ways of doing this, but in this exercise, let me show you the method you want to use. So click on Arc Toolbox, come to Spatial Analyst Tool, scroll down, come to Zona. Then you see Zona Statistics as table. Double click it. Now here, input raster or feature zoo data, that is going to be this point, that is our samples. So click here and choose samples. Then the zona ID, that is going to be the ID we just created. Then input value raster, here you input digital elevation model. Then specify where you want to save it. So here you can just save it as table or any other name you prefer. Click on save. Then here, the statistics type, depending on your preference. If you want all the statistics to be calculated, choose all. But if you are specific, maybe you want only mean, then click on mean. But in this case, let's just choose all, which means the result will involve all statistics. Then click on OK. The table has been created. This is it. If I right click and open, we can see the table and we can see the statistics that has been calculated for it. The mean, minimum, maximum, sum and the likes has been calculated. So close it. Now what we need to do now is to join this table to our sample. So to do that, come to this sample, right click, and you see join and relate. Click join. Now here, choose the field. The field we want to use is the ID field. We want to join it, the table, to that very sample layer. And the field in the table we want to use is ID. That's the common field. Then click on OK. Click yes. So if we come back to sample, right click and open attribute table, you can see that the field in this table has been transferred or joined to these samples. So we can now close this. Now we want to do the relief map. So to do the relief map, come to under spatial analysis tool, come to interpolation, click on it, and want to use IDW method. Double click it. So here, input point features, that is going to be our samples. Choose sample. Then here, Z value. Here we have a lot of fields. If I click on this drop down, you can see the field, the area, minimum, maximum, range, mean. So we are going to use the mean. Click on mean. Then click here to save your outputs. So let's save this as relief map, or just relief. Click on save. You can leave other thing at default. However, come to environment and set the environment. Click here. Then come to processing extent. Here I want the extent to be the same as my study area, which is Karoo. Then scroll down. Then come to raster analysis. Scroll down. Here mask, I want it to be the same as my study area. Then click on OK. So now click on OK to create the relief map. Yes, the relief map has been created. I can now uncheck this. I can click here, then uncheck the digital elevation model. So this is the relief map. So you can now close this. Right click here, come to properties. Under symbology, we want to classify it. Choose the number of classes you want, let's say 15. If you want as much as that, right click here and format the label. So I want it to be one decimal place. Click on OK, then choose your color. You can choose any color of your choice, let's say this color, and click on OK. Yes, you can see this is our relief map. You can uncheck the boundary of our study area. Then this first color, we can change the color to any color of our choice here, just to make it look good. So you can see the relief map. Now we can now take it to layout. So right click and zoom to layer. Then we can change the layout. Let's change it to portrait and click on finish. Yes, this is our relief map. So you can add all other map elements. So in essence, this is how to produce relief map in ArcGIS. I hope you like this video. If you have any question regarding the processes, let's know in the comment section. And if you want any other video on any other map, tell us in the comment section so that we can do the video. Thank you for watching.